弟兄姐妹们平安，欢迎大家参与线上崇拜。这是一个别开生面的崇拜，不论我们处在什么样的光景，面对什么样的挑战，让我们仰赖神的恩典跟仰赖神的怜悯，在这个非常的时期，让我们继续敬拜赞美我们的主，让我们继续敬拜赞美我们的神。 Amen。
对，让我们一起来敬拜我们的神。 Amen。 耶和华他已经行了大事在我们当中。 Amen。
是我光照，耶和华已经为我们行了大事，他在干旱之处使水流成河。我们要欢呼诉说他的作为，我们依靠神就能施展大能，我们要歌颂要欢呼说他的作为，我们依靠神就能施展大能。
Amen。 让我们一起来，耶和华已经行了大事，
耶和华已经为我们行了大事，他命令狂风止息，他波浪就平静，耶和华已经为我们行了大事，他张开双手，我们就得满足。我们要欢呼，诉说他的作为，我们依靠神就能施展大能，我们要歌颂。他将烈火的灵赐给我们，他必带领选民欢呼向前。他将烈火的灵赐给我们，我们要欢呼，
我们要欢呼，
诉说他的作为，
诉说他的作为，
我们依靠神。
我们一起祷告。万军之耶和华上帝，我们在你面前同心寻求你的面。主啊，无论环境如何，我们所面对的挑战多大，主，我们深知你超越这一切，你胜过这一切。主，我们祈求你在这个期间让我们经历你，让我们能够体会到你那真实的怜悯和丰盛的慈爱。求你的圣灵也与我们每个人同在，因为你是超越空间限制的神，你就在这个线上的时候，让我们每一个人在家中也能够体会到，能够听见你要对我们说的话。主啊，求神你祝福我们的线上崇拜，让我们在整个过程蒙神你看顾，也祝福我们的讲员许慧仪牧师，让他所释放的能够成为我们的能力去面对这一场的征战。祈求神你赐下全副的军装，让我们得胜一切。祝福我们以下的时间，祷告奉耶稣的圣名求，阿们。让我们一起同诵主祷文。我们在天上的父，愿人都尊父的名为圣， 愿父的国降临，愿父的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们遇见试探，拯救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是父的，直到永永远远。阿们。
弟兄姐妹，很高兴今天我们能够一起来线上崇拜。
Dear and sisters, we are very glad today that we can participate in the online telecast worship service.
不知道大家现在是抱着怎么样的心情来参加崇拜？
I wonder what sort of feelings that we carry with us as we participate in this service.
有人说这个14天我们就像在过华人新年。
Some people say these 14 days are just like Chinese New Year.
也有人说哇这14天很爽啊，因为可以吃喝玩乐。
Some people say it's so enjoyable that we can eat, drink and be merry at home.
那当然无论是怎么样的心情，我想我们大部分人我们的心情都是有很多的担忧，很多的不安。
Whatever feelings that we may have, I'm sure some of us may feel worried and insecure.
当然我们不单是害怕这个新冠肺炎的传染，更是我们很多地区家里也自水。
Not only that we are worried for the outbreak of the coronavirus, many areas are facing water supply disruption.
那我们举国上下好像都在一个黑暗里面。
It is as if that our entire nation is covered with darkness.
我们是全国一起去面对这个的挑战。
So our entire nation together faces this challenge.
全国，但是更是每一家都一起来面对这个挑战。
Yes, it is the entire nation, but all the more, every home is also facing this challenge.
你知道吗？在圣经里面，在旧约尼希米记也有一段这个的事件哈，有点像现在这样的情况。
Now, do you know that in the Old Testament, that is in the book of Nehemiah, it was recorded an incident that is very similar to what we face now.
就是全国面对一个困难，但是也全家要一起的来努力。
That is the entire nation was facing a challenge, yet every home.Participated together in facing this challenge.
所以我们就看看，先了解一下当时候尼希米记的背景。
Now let us take a look at the background to the book of Nehemiah.
那当时候这个主角哦，这个尼希米哦，他那时候是波斯王的酒政。
So the main character here, Nehemiah, he was the cupbearer to the Persian king.
然后当他听到他的同胞他们被掳回归到耶路撒冷，可是他听到那里的这个情况是城墙是被毁了的。
So he heard that his fellow people, the Jewish people, returned from exile. However, he also got to know that the city wall had collapsed.
然后他就围着他自己的同胞来这个担忧来伤心，因为城墙被毁是很危险的，就是没有东西保护他们的家园。
So he was very worried for his fellow Jews because with the collapse of the city wall, it will pose danger because there was no protection for them.
所以他就想要回到这个家乡来跟百姓们一起的来重修城墙，重修家园。
So he intended to go back to Jerusalem, to his homeland, to rebuild the city wall and to rebuild their homeland.
就像我们刚才说的，而且是每一家都要参与的。
Just as what we mentioned earlier, every home, has to be participating.
而当他们一边重修的时候，更是要一边防范外敌来攻打他们。
So while they were rebuilding the wall with one hand, they also have to guard against their enemies.
其实当时候他们是内忧外患。
So in fact, they were facing trouble from within and without.
那当时候他们这样的境况的时候，尼希米就呼吁，当他回到耶路撒冷，他就呼吁每个人每一家都要为自己的家来征战。
So, when Nehemiah learned this, so he urge that not only the entire nation, but every home has to be participating in this work.
就在尼希米记第四章十四节，尼希米就告诉他们说，当纪念主是大而可畏的，你们要为弟兄、为儿女、为妻子、为你们的家产征战。
In the Nehemiah chapter 4 verse 14, it says, Remember the Lord is great and awesome, and fight for your brothers, your sons, and your daughters, your wives, and your homes.
当他在这样讲的时候，他知道其实当时候的人心里面也是会害怕的，也是会担忧的。
Now, when he was saying this, he also knew that the people at that time were also very worried and anxious.
所以他也强调，当我们都在努力的时候，最重要是耶和华我们的神为我们征战。
So more importantly, he said, as we work together, our God will fight for us.
所以我们可以看到他整大段很大段的这个的经文呢，其实都是在讲着他回到这个耶路撒冷，然后他带动百姓一起的来修造城墙，和建好了过后还是要继续的看守城墙。
So mainly the background of Nehemiah is telling us that after returning to Jerusalem to rebuild the city wall, they have to also be constantly keep watch and safeguard the city wall.
我觉得有一点很特别的是我们要注意的，就是当他们每一家都参与在这个修造城墙和过后看守城墙，每一家负责的就是你的家前面的那一副的城墙。
So I noted that interestingly, every home as they were participating in the rebuilding work, they have to also keep watch of the wall right in front of their house.
这什么意思呢？
Now, what does this mean?
这是看起来是国家的事。
So it seems that this is a matter concerning the country.
但是这个也更是跟你自家是有关系的。
But this is also all the more related to your home affair.
因为你家前面的城墙如果没有被修好啊，就是很危险了，随时敌人就会进来了，整个国家就危险了。
Because if the part of the city wall right in front of your house is not repaired, then you are open to all sorts of dangers.
那所以每一家的参与很重要。
So the participation of every home is equally important.
所以当他们在这个每一家参与来做这个修造城墙的时候，特别有一个经文就讲到他们每一个人是一手做工，一手拿兵器。
So there is a verse here that mentioned that as they were carrying materials and they did their work, with another hand they held a weapon.
那让我想起我看过一套戏是这样子哦，本来是有一个厨师在煮东西的。
I once watched a movie, talking about a chef who was cooking.
那他其实是这个很多档口啊，很多档都是都是煮刺的。
So there were many stalls and they were all cooking different dishes.
不过这样哦，那因为那边很多流氓啊，那个流氓一来啊，这个。他们就厨师就突然间就变成可以打架的，就拿起他们的刀出来啊。
But because at that time there were many rascals around, giving problem. So, while the chef was cooking, so the next moment his hand will hold a knife to protect himself.
所以当经文这边讲说，当时候的人一手做工，一手拿兵器，你可以看到他们是随时准备好的。
So with one hand they carried their building materials, and with another hand they carried a weapon. So they were all ready to fight and protect themselves.
所以他们其实是在一手保护家园，一手准备征战。
So on one hand they guarded their homeland, with another hand they were ready to fight the battle.
弟兄姐妹，你这个时候就要跟你的家人说，我们每一个人都要成为战士。
So at this moment, brothers and sisters, you have to tell your family that we have to be prepared to fight the battle.
然后当时候呢，他们建好了这个的城墙过后，他们每一家都还要继续的看守城墙，为什么？
So after the completion of the rebuilding work, now every home has to also keep watch of the city wall. Now why is that so?
就是说他们不松懈下来，因为当时候城门是有时候会开，有时候会关。
So they cannot be totally relaxed because the city gate was open and closed at an appointed time.
你知道吗，弟兄姐妹，我们在这个这样的时期里面呢，有时候我们的心有时候开，有时候关，但是如果开和关在不对的时间开，不对的时间关，是很危险的。
So at this moment, brothers and sisters, our heart may be open and close at certain times, but if we open our hearts or if we close up our hearts at the incorrect moment, then it can be very dangerous.
那我们会不小心开门给什么呢？我们不小心开门给担忧、不安、恐惧，甚至是很自私。
Now, if we are not careful, what happens if we open our hearts for worry, insecurity, fear, and selfishness to enter our heart?
那我想特别我们在这个政府定下的行动管制令之前和之后，我们都看到很多人的行为都很自私。
Now we can see that before and after the movement restriction order was announced, we could see the selfish behavior of many people.
那并且呢，我也听到有人说，哎呀，我们现在出门很危险嘛，然后我们不用出去买菜啦，现在菜哦，你都可以上网 order， 然后他就会把菜送来你的家，但是送到来我们的家过后，我们又怕，哎呦，那个送的人到底哈安全吗？哈，送到来我们家，我们都还害怕，都还恐惧。
So, in view of the movement restriction order, so many people were thinking that, in view of that, so we can still order and buy our vegetable supplies online. However, some people even worried if the supplies that they receive will be safe and will be good for their consumption.
所以我们知道，其实我们很多弟兄姐妹，很多人我们一直处在一个担忧里面，不安里面。
So, brothers and sisters, many of us are still living in fear and insecurity.
但是这个并不是上帝要给我们的。
However, this is what not given by the Lord.
那弟兄姐妹，你知道吗？有时候我们又不小心关门，对着上帝关门，我们的心对着上帝关门，对着上帝的话语关门。
Our brothers and sisters, sometimes when we are not careful, we will also close up our hearts. We close up our hearts to God and to His words.
然后我们就一直开门给那个担忧、恐惧。
Yet we open our hearts for worry, insecurity, and fear.
所以我想问大家，在这十四天里面，其实你的心思是在怎么样的境况底下呢？
So I would like to ask you during these 14 days, what are your thoughts?
有些人说，哦，我的妈妈在家是做母老虎哈。
Oh, some may say my mother at home is just like the female tiger.
那有些人在家就是什么啊、哦？就是反而是那个生活更加是生活作息更加是不好的。
For some, probably in their daily routine and in their daily lives and daily interaction with their family, they are not so well related.
那现在我们说，哎呦，很多时间跟家人在一起，可是却很多人可能是一直看新闻啊，一直看手机或者是看戏，反而跟家人不一定有沟通。
For some people, they keep watching the news, movies or their mobile phones, but with minimal interaction with their family members.
这个是没有沟通啊，有一些是太激烈沟通。
Now this is a non-communication, while for some they overly communicate.
你懂什么是太激烈沟通吗？我们看，你看中国啊，他们封城过后啊，结果很多的人要离婚哈，因为在家太多时间相处吵架哈。
Do you know what is over communication? For example, the lockdown of the cities in China has actually caused many couples to divorce because they had too much time together.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们该如何去保守我们的心思呢？
So, brothers and sisters, how do we safeguard our thoughts?
因为我们要保守心思了，才懂得保护我们的家。
So, if we are able to safeguard our thoughts, only then we can safeguard our home.
我们的心思要向神敞开，向神的话敞开。
So we have to open our minds and our hearts to God and to His words.
那我们有三个很容易记的 FOC。
So we have these three letters which we can remember very easily. FOC.
放心啊，牧师不是要送东西给你们哦。
It's not that pastor is giving you some free gifts.
那第一点就是关于我们的家庭，我们跟家人在一起，不是在一起而已，而是有美好的时光，能够一起建立关系，一起祷告的时光。
So F is for family. That is not only that we are together, be with our family, but also to spend quality time with them, and we can pray together.
一起亲近神，当然也可以一起玩乐，就是在一起是真正有沟通的。
We can together seek God, and we can also together have fun, but we are truly spending time with one another.
O 呢，是我们要遵行政府所规定的这个行动管制令。
O is to obey the movement control order that is imposed by the government.
你知道吗？当时候，这个当尼西米告诉他的这个同胞们要怎么样一起来重修城墙，每一家参与，他们从重修到修好、建好到看守，经文说他们如同一人，他们都是同心、遵行和配合。
So, during the entire rebuilding work, from the rebuilding work and all the way to the completion and to safeguarding the completed city wall, they were all together, they were all one-hearted, and they were all united.
那就像刚才我们说的，因为每一个人、每一家的参与，你不单是在国家层面是配合，更是在自家，对你自己的家来说，更是保护你的家。
So it is not only that it is an affair that concerns the entire nation, but it is also an affair that concerns every home, that every home has to play a part to safeguard their own home.
那当然，这段时间我们在家不是放纵我们自己。
Of course, we do not overly indulge ourselves at home.
我们要照顾健康，照顾家人。
We also have to take care of our health and also our family members.
就算是我们在家，有经文说我们吃喝做什么都要荣耀上帝才行。
Even at home, the Bible says, even when we eat and drink, let us also glorify God.
那让我们就一起来做个尽责的天上的公民，也做一个尽责的地上的公民。
Therefore, let us be a responsible heavenly citizen and a responsible earthly citizen.
那当然，当我们说我们要保护我们的家的时候，那更重要的，就像尼西米跟他的百姓、他的同胞说的，更重要，我们的后面是有上帝，上帝耶和华，他保护我们，他是不打盹的，他保护我们免受一切的灾害。
Now, just as we could see that in Nehemiah, how the people guarded their home and rebuilt the city wall, we also know that behind this, our God is fighting for us, and He watches over you. He does not slumber, and He will protect you from all harm.
那所以刚才说，哎，我们知道了，我们都要起来，每一个人都要一起来保护我们的家。然后记得吗？刚才我们说，因为一手要拿兵器嘛，所以我们到底要拿什么兵器呢？
So as we mentioned earlier, as we safeguard our home, we need to also carry weapon with us. So what sort of weapon do we carry?
弟兄姐妹，这种时候我们就要以祷告来征战。
So at this moment, brothers and sisters, we need to fight with prayer.
那当他们当时候在修建城墙，一边工作也一边拿兵器，那意思是指是警醒的。
So, while they were working with one hand and with the other, they carried a weapon. It shows that they have to be alert.
所以我们这段时间抗疫这段时间，我们同样也应当是警醒的，不是在放假的。
So, during this time, as we fight the outbreak of the disease, we have to be also alert as life goes on, and it is not for us to go on holiday.
就像刚才我们一开始就强调的，警醒，从我们的心思开始警醒。
So to be alert, as we mentioned earlier, it begins from our own hearts.
你知道吗？在圣经旧约到新约，每一次有很大的挑战的时候，很大的灾难的时候，那也是神要人转向他的时候。
So do you know that in the Bible, from the Old Testament till the New Testament, each time when the people face major challenge, it is also time that when God wants the people to turn their eyes on Him.
所以这段时间，我们更是要以祷告亲近神，寻求神的旨意。
So this is also a time when we pray and draw close to God and to seek His will.
好，我们就看两段的经文。当我们警醒征战的时候，神就为我们征战。
So when we are alert and as we fight the battle, our God will also fight the battle for us.
那这个尼希米他们在建城墙52天完成，其实是神迹来的。
So for the rebuilding of the wall, it only took 52 days, and it was really a miracle.
所以经文在六章那里就告诉我们，知道的人都说，竟然可以在52天完成，这完全是神的作为。
So in the chapter 6, it says that for all of them who could see that it was completed in only 52 days,This work had been done with the help of our God.
所以弟兄姐妹，当我们参与，我们警醒、祷告，我们不这个随便的度日的时候，我们寻求神、依靠神，神就必定为我们征战。
So as we are alert, even as life goes on, and we do not waste our life, so our God will also help us and fight the battle for us.
所以这个时候我们要拿起兵器，我们要怎么样祷告呢？我们用三个字母来祷告。
So as we carry our weapons and we pray, so we also pray according to these three letters.
第一个，我们宣告祷告。
First of all, we proclaim as we pray.
那我们可以宣告神的名。
We can proclaim God's name.
我们可以宣告神的话。
We can proclaim God's word.
如果你不懂得怎么样，你就从诗篇里面，诗篇有很多很好的这个的经文，可以直接用来宣告祷告的。
So if you're not sure how to do this, you can refer to the book of Psalms, because there are many good prayers in the book of Psalms which you can refer to.
那其实在尼希米记第四章，当尼希米他在这个呼吁大家来建城墙的时候，他自己就做了这样的宣告，就是宣告神为他们征战。
So, in chapter 4, Nehemiah, when he urged the people to come and to rebuild the wall, he also proclaimed that our God will fight for us.
第二呢，我们也要做认罪的祷告。
Secondly, we have to have a prayer of repentance.
当尼希米一听到他的家园的这个景况的时候，他第一件事情就是围着自己的国家来做认罪祷告。
So Nehemiah, when he first learned of the condition surrounding his homeland, the first thing he did was to pray for forgiveness for his country.
我相信我们这段时间很多人，我们都祷告求神保守我们。让这个病菌不会传到我们的家。那更重要的，我们也不要忘记一起为国家祷告，全家大小为国家祷告，也为医护人员祷告，就是为整个这个抗疫的情况来祷告。
So at this moment, many of us are praying for ourselves and for our families so that the virus will not attack us, will not attack anyone of us in our home, but also let us, together with our entire family, also pray for the entire nation and also to remember the medical team who are on duty at this moment.
我们可以用这个按着这个历代志下7:14的这个经文，围着我们的国家来做认罪祷告。
We can pray according to 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14 as we pray a prayer of repentance for our nation.
那这个经文告诉我们说，耶和华说，这称为我名下的子民，若是谦卑祷告，寻求我的面，转离他们的恶行，我必从天上垂听，赦免他们的罪，医治他们的地。
So it says here, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land.
那我们就抓着这个应许来为国家做认罪祷告。
So let us take hold of this promise and pray this prayer of repentance for our nation.
那第三个是什么呢？我们要献上感谢为祭给神。
Thirdly,is that we have to offer a sacrifice of thanks offering to God.
像尼希米，他在这个乌云的情况，在他的国家面对这个困难的情况里面，他怎么样带领百姓同胞一起的来努力，围着家园来做这个修造保护，然后他们也整个过程从开始到他们建好整个过程，他们都是敬畏神的。
So we could see that from the beginning of the rebuilding of the wall, as Nehemiah urged them, so we could see that in the entire process, all of them honored God in all that they do.
那他们在这个尼希米的带领之下，人人都仰望神，转向神，他们就经历到在神凡事都能。
So as they honored God and they looked to God in everything that they do, they could truly experience the great power of God.
就像在诗篇五十篇这里所说的
，Just like in Psalms 50, it tells us.
这段经文告诉我们，在患难之日，我们要以感谢为祭献给神。
So it tells us to sacrifice thank offerings to God.
那我读给大家听，经文说：你们要以感谢为祭献与神，又要向至高者还你的愿，要在患难之日求告我，我必搭救你，你也要荣耀我。
Let me read this to all of us. Sacrifice thank offerings to God.Fulfill your vows to the Most High and call upon me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you and you will honor me.
刚才我们说他们在修城墙的时候，一手做工，一手拿兵器，你知道吗？当时候他们也有人是负责敬拜的。
Now earlier we mentioned that with one hand they were rebuilding the wall. With another hand they held a weapon in their handNow, do you also know that there were some other people who were responsible conduct praise and worship?
你可能会想，哇，那时候这样紧张的时候啊，要快点修好城墙，不然怕敌人来攻击，又有内忧又有外患，这样紧张的时候，还有谁这样得空啊？要去敬拜赞美啊
？So you may wonder, it was such a critical moment, that the wall has to be rebuilt as soon as possible.Where do we have so much time for praise and worship?
那所以我们就可以看到他们整个的很重要的神学，他们的这个观念，他们的心思知道敬拜神那是最重要的。
So they had the right theology, the right mindset that worship is the utmost important.
所以弟兄姐妹，让我们全家都一起以祷告征战，包括儿童。
So let us.Together with our entire family, including the children, to fight this battle with prayer.
我们可以在家跟家人一起有家庭祭坛，一起敬拜，一起读经，一起祷告的时间。
We can have a time of a family altar where we can read the scripture and we can pray and worship together.
那我们也可以在小组里面跟教会这个神的家的家人来一起的亲近神。
We can also together with the family of God in the church to also draw close to God.
当然，我们是透过线上的这个小组啦。
Of course, now we are doing this in the form of an online group.
那所以，当我们要这样来警醒面对现在的情况的时候。
So as we are alert, as we face this current situation,
弟兄姐妹，让我们全家一起成为战士。
Let us and our entire family be warrior to fight this battle.
就像这个卡通的戏一样啊、
哦。Just like this cartoon.
那我们要一起的警醒，我们要做个尽责的天上的公民和地上的公民。
We have to be alert, and we have to be a responsible citizen on earth, and also a responsible heavenly citizen.
依靠那保护我们的耶和华，我们一起的守护我们的家。
As we rely on the Almighty God, let us also protect and safeguard our homeland.
保守我们的心思，记得刚才我们说，我们不开门给恐惧忧虑，我们开门给神的话语。
Also to safeguard our thoughts and our minds, remember earlier we mentioned, let us not open our hearts to worry, insecurity and fear.
因为我们知道耶和华为我们征战。
Because we know that our God will fight for us.
让我们一起祷告。
Let us pray together.
爱我们的阿爸天父，父神，我们感谢，我们赞美，因为父神，当我们在面对这个情况的时候，我们知道你是为我们征战的神。主，我们更要感恩，因为你的话语提醒我们，当我们这十四天在家里面，我们跟家人在一起的时候，我们乃是要警醒度日，更是重要的是，纵使我们许多人心里面有担忧有不安，但是你的话语告诉我们，不单是你为我们征战，更是耶稣说，这世上有苦难，但是在耶稣里面我们有平安。主，我们奉主名，要叫我们的家人心里面的这个不安、恐惧都要离开他们的心。主啊，我们奉主名宣告，耶稣的平安要来到我们的家，来到我们家人的心思。主，你保守我们，让我们学习聆听你的声音，学习在这段时间里面更多亲近你。跟家人，我们要一起的守卫我们的家，一起的全国来啊，这个一起的抗疫。在这段时间，我们更是带着盼望，更是不单是带着警醒，我们也要在任何时刻，我们都要荣耀神你的名，愿神你赐福，你带领。主啊，我们都要起来，我们全家大小都要成为战士，以祷告来征战。因为主，我们知道，当我们警醒，我们以祷告征战的时候，主你就为我们征战。我们赞美，愿神你赐福带领。祷告奉主耶稣的圣名祈求，阿们。
愿主耶和华用脸光光照你们，施恩赐福于你们，保守你们以及你们的全家。有愿我主耶稣基督的恩惠，天父上帝无比的慈爱，圣灵保卫师与我们每一个人同在，从今时直到永永远远，阿们。